camped at Trout Lake Camp last night, about 2 miles south of here. I'm on the east bank of the river, and the goal is just to make it around the entire little loop here in the state park for the weekend. Lots of stairs, a lot of routes, up and down paths on this side of the river so far. A lot of great waterfall scenes. When I was on YouTube, I saw a lot of great pictures of the waterfalls, but not too many videos covering the trails. Okay, Superior Hiking Trail Association does a great job keeping up on these trails and the campsites. This by far is the most scenic of them all. You can see just more waterfalls. Some of those cool pothole features. And this is pretty typical of what the trail's been. You know, you've been using the roots as steps. Just a little technical, but definitely planning, taking it a little slower, especially if you're carrying a full pack. Sound that you hear, that's what I heard at my campsite all last night. Just sleeping in my tent, it just put me right to sleep. Got up in the morning, went and filtered some water out of the river. Phenomenal. Had me eggs and bacon this morning for breakfast. Talked to a nice family that were doing a little backpacking trip. Coffee. Packed up, got 2 miles down the road. Not in too much of a hurry this week, weekend. Okay, this bridge I'm going across, this is pretty typical. You know, it takes a lot of time and effort to take these boards out here, put them together. People that volunteer to do their time out here is phenomenal. It's just a wonderful resource. I'm surprised I haven't ran into too many other people. It's really quiet out here, even on a weekend. Oh, this is neat. I don't know if that's a step or a... or a bench. It makes, looks like it makes a great bench for a good view. Nice, it just phenomenal views out here. So I should be coming up on Highway 45. show you, you can find urban art even out here. Not too bad. Once you cross the bridge, you're going to kind of go down this road for a little bit, about an eighth of a mile. Don't get too discouraged. There is a sign up ahead here. And yep, here's the Blaze and the Superior Hiking Trail sign, and a nice little bridge. I think this is parking right here. I don't know if it's overnight parking. I think we got a couple options, but either the stairs or the more scenic route. Not too bad. I'm gonna go down this way. Just kind of see what we got. Oh wow. What a view. Is this down there? Oh. Oh, look at the moss on the trees. Just a gorgeous day. A couple sprinkles last night. Nothing major. Everything was dry this morning. Oh, just awesome. Look at that. And then there's the little older blue Blazes. Those have been really helpful. Technical through here. See a bridge. No trolls? Good. Figure we're gonna go straight up. That behind me is a pine tree, and you can tell by the way it is. How neat is that? Breathing hard because I'm doing quite a little bit of a climb here. Carrying about 25 pounds today. A little more than what I like. I kind of brought some comfort items and brought a little chair. Thank you. tell you, when REI sees me walk through the door, they get all excited. Cha-ching! Once I got through and packed the other day, went through all the stuff I wanted to bring, and then weighed my pack out, decided I needed to get rid of about 5 pounds, and I got rid of about 4 or 5 things that I really didn't need, and that's usually how I do it. I'm only about 5 miles from my truck. And I just brought a little poncho. Left all my other rain gear in the truck. Just brought it just to see. It was sprinkling a little bit on the way up here. Forecast is pretty dry. So I went ahead and went with that. Shave a couple pounds off. Make sure you bring something. You never know what the rain's going to bring. Of course, this time of year, lighter sleeping bag. Chair is probably not too necessary. It's about 1 pound, 8 ounces. Brought my heavier stove and an extra little frying pan so I cooked some eggs this morning. You know, typically I bring like a little pot and a canister stove, or an alcohol stove. A little heavy on the cook gear too. And I always pack an extra day worth of food than what I anticipate. You never know. Being so close to the truck, never too worried about it. You get on these multi-day, ooh, got some nice tracks. Looks like we got some bear tracks here. Let's see if I can get them. Nice little bear tracks. Let's see what else we got. Oh, that's why we hang our clothes up at night, or our food up at night. Oh, that's a nice one right there. Yeah, big size. Yeah, looks like he's coming through here. Hey, bear. Hey, bear. Something moving over there. Hey, bear. Well, just talking to Lisa, my boss. And said she had a bear. Some more tracks in through here. Hey, bear. So, on this side of the river, you got 2 campsites, and this is the one I'm going to stop at for lunch. It's Cut Log. At first I thought it was this. That's why they call it Cut Log. But I'll show you. I kind of walked over here. Dropped my pack. I'm going to sit here and have lunch for an hour. I am in no hurry at all. Pretty typical fire pit out here. Really nice. But this is why they call it Cut Log. Somebody got a little adventurous with a chainsaw. It's pretty neat. I don't know if I'd sit in there, but it's kind of neat. People are wondering, well, how do you go to a bathroom out here? Well, here's the latrine. But this is kind of neat. So you go back here. I don't know if there's an occupied sign or not. I definitely wouldn't camp back here. There you go, a throne with a view. By the way, make sure you bring your own toilet paper and hand sanitizer. Just over the hill, out of sight. I still prefer to go a bit off the trail and dig a cat hole, but that works too. Boy, a lot of these little berries. I have to look and see what those are. The blueberries, or I'm sure they're not edible, or at least I'm not gonna try. That's gonna be what I'm gonna look up. Did see some raspberries. Had one or two of those earlier. Those were good. Now I'm gonna have some tuna and mayonnaise and tortilla. So I'm gonna turn this off. Oh, my hat was just soaked. Clean that when I get home. So here's cut log. I wonder if these are a code. Wow, that was quite a trip. Whew. Somebody lost a sock or ran out of toilet paper. Course, if you gotta go down, you gotta go up. Wow. Okay. All right, well, it rained last night, but not raining now. Broke camp, didn't want a good time. You can see where the dry spot is where my tent was. Not the most comfortable spot, but I got the tent put away a little wet. I'll just have to take it out when I get home. This is the last day. Decided not to cook breakfast this morning. Gonna go ahead and grab something on the way home. I got 2 miles to the truck, maybe a little more, not too much. It's supposed to be really beautiful. A little gloomy today. It's supposed to have some more rain coming in, but you know what? I think we'll just suck it up, embrace the suck. So I'm gonna have my little breakfast this morning, just to get me by, and I'm gonna head down the trail. Okay, well, I just had to stop and check this out. This is gorgeous. This is a long way down. I'm trying to be careful here because I still have my pack on and I don't want to lose my balance. It's softer. Oh, that is just completely gorgeous. It's like a big bowl in here. Pretty much almost to the truck here. I went down the other side. That is just completely gorgeous. Brown color comes from the water. I drank a lot of that water. It was good. That is just completely cool. a bridge up here. Way cooler view. This is pretty much where I started. So. Yeah, and I'm off to the truck. Get some breakfast, shower, I stink. And maybe some other items. And, that was my little weekend adventure.